Hey guys, IDGeek121 here, Root 280 player extraordinaire, and today we're going to learn about how to play Root 280 story style with the start boost. So let's go ahead and get started. So beginning is as normal. We will grab this line of rings. As we get over here, we're at full driving speed, and we're going to hit the downhill, and that'll increase our speed even more. So at this point, we want to pop our drift. So you'll see, if we look at the input display, I actually let go of the A button here, and I start turning, and I press A again. And now I'm drifting, and I have higher speed than normal. And we gain speed as we go over these downhills. This is the first important part of Route 280, where we need to boost as we hit this bottom flat piece of ground. The reason for this is because going over this hill and falling onto the flat ground is going to lose a lot of speed. Along with that, depending on how you take this corner, you can hit the ceiling and that'll lower your horizontal speed some. So when you hit the ground, press the Y button, do your boost, and now you're going to go through this whole flat part at full speed. We're going to grab the line of rings here in the middle. So this might be the first kind of weird part. We're not going to go on the inside corner because that's going to lose a lot of speed just because of the grade of the incline. It's pretty steep. So we're actually going to go in the middle, where it's less steep. We'll have higher speed on the straightaway part, just by going through the middle. Now, you'll see we're at 36 rings, and what this will mean for right now, there are no balloons to like fuck up this number. So that means that when we get these next four rings, we're going to get a boost. So it's important, if you have all the rings from before, you need to grab four rings from here. If you missed some rings earlier, you can make it up here. It doesn't lose much time, like usually less than a frame even. So missing rings earlier isn't the worst thing in the world. So we're going to grab this double line of rings, and we're going to go towards the balloon. We're going to grab it. So, you'll see we got a 42:30 for our lap time. What's difficult about this is there's going to be this blue car behind where it says time extended. Let me like frame advance so you can see a little more. This motherfucker will be in your way for going too fast. If you get anything faster than a 42:20, you might be in trouble. So, using these strats, you usually won't unless you're like perfect. If you're perfect, you can get like 42:18, 42:16, but if you're any faster than 42:20, you're gonna be in trouble. But if you're within like 42:20 and 42:40, you should be in the clear for this. This is the hardest part of lap two. It's right at the beginning. You're gonna just squeeze right by. Feel free to like frame advance on YouTube using the not the arrow keys, but like the pointed brackets, I guess, like comma and period. You can frame advance, look at the inputs that I do. It's just like a hard right and a hard left to get around here, but it's pretty tight and you have to be in a certain time frame to get it, but with practice you'll get it very consistently. Now as we approach this hill, I'm going to let go of the A button briefly so we catch this downhill just a little bit. And you're going to see if we actually go back and look at that. In midair, I also let go of the A button so that we catch this downhill. This is the difference between if we landed here, we'd have like 11 speed or something. If we land here, we're gonna have around 12.5 speed. So we really want to land on the downhill. It makes that much of a difference. And when we hit this flat part of the ground, I'm going to boost. And now we want to ride the outside of this wall. If we try to do like a sharp turn on the inside, you can't do it at full speed. It's just not possible. So in order to preserve this boost speed we have, we're going to just ride along this wall. And it's a lot faster to do that than to make it almost all the way around the corner and hit a wall really hard and lower yourself to like 12 speed. If we do this, we preserve 14 speed throughout this entire turn and through this part. Next important part. We're going to actually brake here. This is the first time in a video that I've shown off the brake. The brake does not work when you hold the A button. So we want to brake to hit this downhill part. But you just have to make sure you're not holding A, otherwise it's not going to work. You could alternatively just hold A or let go of A for like a long time, but hitting the brake is a little bit faster because you want to catch this downhill. If you land on this flat part, we're not going to have a boost that we want to use for a while. So we need to hit this downhill so we have good speed. We're going to get our boost around here. We want to save this boost till we get around this corner. Try to avoid this wall if you can, but if you can't, it's not a big deal. You don't lose too much time from it. And now, once we're at the top, the apex of our jump, we're going to boost. So 124.23 for our lap two. That's not too bad, but you're gonna see as we get to the S curve, we're actually going to run into a problem. And that problem is this dumb blue car. So there are actually going to be two parts to this. I'm going to show off a backup if you say run into this dumb car, or if you run into the wall and lose a lot of speed. I'm going to show the ring backup. Then at the end of the video, I'm going to show what you do if you make it around the corner without losing much or any speed. We don't need those rings. It's not really important. We got a boost on ourselves already. Now we get over here. This is like a perfect execution turn, but the car was in the way because we were just at like a dumb time frame. Like, if we had a 124.4 or something, you probably wouldn't have hit the car. If we had a 124.15, we would not have hit the car. We were just in a really, really bad timing window. But if this happens, it's okay. You can still get a 241 really easily. Not easily, but you can still get it without doing anything too wild. So we boost here. We're gonna grab that balloon. So right now we're at 10 boost points. Gonna grab all these rings, that puts us at 16. Gonna have to go around that white car, it's just right in the way. This is gonna be the last of the things where you have to like let go of A. So we'll show that off really quick. You just let go for a really short amount of time so we hit the downhill there. So the tunnel of love is difficult, but there isn't really much to say about it, unfortunately. It's just, if there's anything to say, it's better to hit a wall than it is to hit a car. So if you have to choose between one and the other, grind against a wall for a little bit of time, because you'll probably slow down less. And just get a feel for how they like move. It's kind of like they stick with one side for about 2 seconds and then they swerve to the other side for about 2 seconds. That's just kind of how it goes. Now, within these first four rings, we're at 16 boost points right now. So once we grab these four rings, we have a boost again. So I boost. And now we're just going to grab all the rings coming towards the end of the stage. And just make sure not to hit the taxi as you round this corner. But if you take it on the inside, you probably won't. Unless you're a little bit faster than this. So, what sort of time is this going to give us? Dude, the anticipation's probably killing you, isn't it? .241.04. So, these strats should be able to get you good 241 times. Even if you are a little bit slower, you're still within that 241 range. Now we're going to transition to a better one that I just did a little bit ago. And it's going to have a much better handling of, like, the S-turn. We're just going to cover lap 3 because lap 1 and lap 2 are about the same. Here, let's step back a little bit. Alright. So, we're going into lap 3. We're a little bit earlier this time. We're at 124.10. So, with this sort of time, you can make it around the S-curve. You're going to notice I actually do bonk the wall, but I don't lose a lot of speed. Thankfully. So, I do actually get to do the full strats. With some practice, you'll be able to tell whether you lose a lot of speed or not. So, we're going to do something a little bit different. On that downhill, we're not at full speed. So, you're going to see as we go through this, we're going to be a little bit behind of where we were if we boosted when we rounded this corner, but by the end we're going to fly past the other one, and you'll see how. So I try to make it around this corner, but I didn't dedicate hard enough to the turn, so I didn't quite make it, but I didn't lose a lot of speed from that, so I actually keep going. No boost right now. I get the 10 ring. We're going to get the 6 ring on the back side there. And you're going to notice that this white car is actually going to be further ahead. That's because we didn't boost when we rounded that corner. If we did, we would have been, this white car would have been like around here. But because we didn't boost, it's up here. So we can just kind of slip in right through there. Pretty nifty. Don't hit the taxi if you can avoid it, but if you can't, you know, you're on a downhill, so you won't lose too much time. Let go of the A button there to hit the downhill. Tunnel of love. I had to get around this car a little bit differently because I'm a little slower right now again. And this is where the big difference comes in. As I get over top of this hill, I'm going to boost. Grab those rings. Now I have another boost right now. And the idea of this strat is that we're going to have two more boosts. We're going to use two more boosts before the ending. So, when we get up here, if you were keeping track of the number of rings in like your boost counter, if we get all of these rings, we're going to get a boost. But since we already have the boost, we don't want to get it right now, because otherwise we'd overwrite the new boost with our old one. So, we're going to purposely avoid a few rings here. If you've been grabbing all the rings we've been grabbing so far, you need to avoid at least one ring. Like, just one ring. But you can avoid up to six and still be okay. So, just, you know, don't worry about it too much. Just grab most of the rings, but not all. See, I missed three rings there. That's fine. So, if you saw right there, once we got to the uphill, Once we got up here, we boosted. And now we're flying down this part with full boost speed. And we get the boost on the last line of six rings. And you saw we were way ahead of the taxi compared to the time before. And now we're coming up to the end with a much better time than we got before. This strat saves about a second in game time over the other strat. You'll see we got a 240.17. Really good. That's a really, really good time. And that's the kind of stuff that you can get if you don't mess up the S-curve. If you do mess it up, though, it's not bad. You will lose a little bit of time, of course, but it's not the worst time loss in the world, and you can still recover, and you can still get 241s. I believe in all of you. And yeah, that's about it for this video. For the next video, we're going to cover some really, really dumb wall bonks that you can do on the stage in order to get lots of speed where you were not intended to. And with those strats, you can get 239 and even better. I didn't want to include them all in this video because this is like a safe route, I guess. This is the story style route. But the next one's going to be, you know, more IL oriented, or for people who really want to like take it to the top level. So yeah, that's about it. See ya.